Today, I'm going to show you how to connect two routers on the same network the correct way. Now, there's two main methods on being able to do this, so let me show you. So first, you're going to have your modem over here, and the default IP on most modems is 192.168.100.1. Now, the back of this modem has two Ethernet ports. This particular modem is a Aeris SB8200, and I do want to let you know that under most circumstances, you will only use this first Ethernet port. The exception to this is if your ISP supports multi-gig, then you can use the second connection in a link aggregation or lag to be able to have up to 2 gigabits of throughput, provided that your router supports that by using two separate ports. Now, that's beyond the scope of this video, but if you're interested in something like that, drop a comment down below and let me know. Now, your modem should have an Ethernet cable connected from here over to the WAN port on your first router. If your first and second router are different manufacturers, then you need to do a little bit more legwork to properly set this up. Now, what some people do is they will connect from their LAN port over here over to the Ethernet port on the second router. And if it is a different manufacturer of a router, what ends up happening is you end up creating two completely separate networks. Now, let's say that this router here is a 192.168.0.1, and your other router, let's just say that that is a 192.168.10.1. So this is the IP address that would be internal on this network here, and you would be able to see this IP over here, but if you were connected on this router, you would not be able to see this IP over here. Why is that, you ask? Well, a couple of reasons. One being that they are completely different networks and they don't have routes to each other. And also secondly, because you're passing through the WAN port on the second router, that has a firewall on it that does not allow traffic to come through unless if you build out the rules to do so. While you can run a network like this, it becomes very tedious, maintenance-wise, to be able to allow traffic in from the outside over to the inside on the second router, because you would have what's called double NAT or double network address translation. And basically you have to have rules on the primary router to route the traffic for whatever particular port over to the IP address that was being given from the first router over to the second router. And then on the second router, putting in another rule set for that port and then mapping that to whatever device that is behind that second router. So there's a better way to do this. Now, what you typically want to do is take an Ethernet cable and connect it from one of the LAN ports on one router over to a LAN port on the other router. Then on the second router, and it's going to be different from manufacturer to manufacturer, what you want to do is turn it into a access point. So you'll have to refer to your manual for your particular make and model and turn this into a access point. Now, some models will want you to connect the WAN port instead, and then it becomes just a straight access point without a built-in switch. So it's going to depend on the model that you have, but most of the times I see where they just connect right in from WAN to LAN, and then you will inherit the DHCP from the first router. That is the dynamic host control protocol that is basically a server on the first router that assigns an IP address to whatever device that is being connected to from the second router. Now, the next thing that is very important is that once you have this in a access point mode is to set its SSID. Let's say your first router you have set up as just home Wi-Fi, and then you might have, you know, _5G for the 5 gigahertz one, and then this without the 5G for the standard 2.4 gigahertz. On the second router, if you end up using the same name, and because they are different manufacturers, then they don't necessarily adhere to the same standards on how they approach things for the network. So what will happen is if you use the same exact SSID, then your device might be confused on which one to connect to. And that can also cause problems with the DHCP lease tables over on the first router, where you might have to reboot it every so often to fix whatever problems that you're having with your devices. The fix to that is call this something else. So let's say like home Wi-Fi 2 and home Wi-Fi 2 _5G. Now, it's up to you if you want to combine your SSIDs on each of the routers while still keeping them separate and allow the routers to determine if the device should be connected on the 2.4 gigahertz or 5 gigahertz network. But in a lot of cases, it's simpler just to keep them separate. Next, I'm going to show you how AI Mesh works. And basically, you need two ASUS routers to do this. And with the AI Mesh firmware, you essentially create either a wireless backhaul, or if you have Ethernet cabling throughout your home or office, you can connect it over a wired link as well, and then have a wireless backhaul as a failover. So in case that cable accidentally comes unplugged or fails, then it will automatically switch over to a wireless backhaul and still continue to expand the coverage of your Wi-Fi. Now, I've given up on my handwriting and just typed everything in here for you guys. So the modem is still 192.168.100.1, and the first router is 192.168.0.1. Now, when you install the AI Mesh firmware, you will have the master router search for and connect to the secondary one. If you are doing this over wireless, it is very important that where you place the secondary router still needs to have good wireless coverage, because any client that connects over to it is then relying on the wireless coverage from the secondary router to the primary router. Now, for some potential problems with this configuration, you might have certain clients, say for example, like a garage door opener or even a doorbell, that depending on how the coverage overlaps between the two routers, the device might not know what to do as far as which one it needs to be connected to, because they will be using the same SSID. Now, you can go into the ASUS firmware and adjust this so that a particular client will not be switched back and forth automatically, and that might help. But usually planning out the overlap and coverage areas with both devices is the best mitigation to cause the least amount of headaches when implementing something like this.